What's good, everybody? This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters, the biggest Miami Hurricane fan ever. Guys, today we are going to be talking about the real number system, and we're going to be taking numbers and we're going to identify and classify them using this system. So let's get started off with a rational number, right? So an irrational number in decimal form, right, is going to be a decimal that does not end or does not repeat. Okay, so let's write that down. Okay, let's go on to the next criteria. So remember that irrational numbers are going to be all imperfect squares, okay? So if you have an imperfect square, it's an irrational number. And then the last thing you guys need to know, whole numbers are not irrational, okay? So if you see a whole number, 9 times out of 10 is going to be rational, all right? And let's see if we could just list about 2 examples of an irrational number. So let's use pi, right? So let's put example. We have pi, because that is a decimal that does not end. And then let's also do the square root of 2, because that's an imperfect square. We know that decimal will not end. All right, so that's the very first one. Let's go over to rational numbers. So for one, rational numbers are all whole numbers. So all whole numbers are rational. Okay. Two, all perfect squares are rational. And then for our very last criteria, right, that we're going to be talking about today, when we have rational numbers in decimal form, right, these decimals will end and it will repeat, okay? And we're going to write down about 2 or 3 examples so that we just know we're on the same page for rational numbers. So let's do the square root of 100, right? That's a perfect square. That is equal to 10. That is a rational number. Let's do 5 over 10, right? When we put that in decimal form, that's just 0.5. That decimal ends. So it is a rational number, all right? Okay. And in the very last example, let's just slide out some. Let's do 1 over 3, which is 0.33, and we know that's going to repeat, all right? Repeating decimal. All right, so let's keep on going. We're going to go down to integers. So what is an integer, right? So we should know that an integer are going to be all the whole numbers and their opposites, all right? So all whole numbers and their opposite. So what does that mean, Mr. Peters? That means the negative side, right? So if we talk about 5, its opposite is just negative 5, okay? So that's what we mean by whole numbers and their opposites. So we should know that integers are not decimals, right? Or fractions. The only time we're going to have a fraction as an integer is if we could reduce that fraction to a whole number. So let's put some integer examples first, right? We have negative 1, 0, and positive 1. Let's say we had something like negative 10 over 5. So 10 over 5 is not a whole number, right? But if we divide 10 by 5 or reduce that fraction, we'll get negative 2, and negative 2 is an integer. Okay? All right, let's go on to the next one, whole numbers. All right, so when we talk about whole numbers, guys, it is literally what it says. So for whole numbers, all right, let's write the definition first. So we're talking about all the positive integers, right? And I'm just going to put in parentheses so we don't get confused. Positive whole numbers, that's all. And we'll abbreviate number. Okay? So when we talk about whole numbers, we're talking about all our positive whole numbers starting from zero. So we have 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So as long as it's a positive whole number, it's going to fall under this classification for real numbers, okay, guys? All right. And let's see if we could go on to the last one. So natural numbers and whole numbers, they're very similar. They're basically the same thing except for one number. So let's start off with definition first. Oops. So natural numbers are all the counting positive numbers. Okay. So Mr. Peters, what does that mean? So we're talking about, switch colors. We're talking about numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4. So whole numbers and natural numbers are the same exact thing, except 0 is not included for natural numbers. And that is the biggest difference between both sets. Apart from that, guys, they're the same exact thing. They're both positive whole numbers. Natural numbers just does not include 0. Okay? So guys, we're going to wrap this video on up today. Before you go, please remember, if a number is irrational, it cannot be rational. It has to be one or the other. 2, if it is a rational number, there is a very likely chance that it can also be an integer, whole number, natural number. Okay? And very last thing, I'm highlighting all of our abbreviations for each of these type of whole numbers. So if you see on a worksheet or a test, you guys should know that N stands for natural, W stands for whole numbers, Z is for our integers, Q is for rational numbers, and I is for irrational. Most 9 times out of 10, guys, all of these are considered real numbers, and we use R to classify real. But I would not worry about that because all of these numbers are classified as real numbers. Well, thank you guys for joining us today. This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters, biggest Miami Hurricane fan ever. Please make sure you guys like, subscribe to our video, and leave any comments for us. Thank you guys for joining today.